How's it going, everybody? This is Seth Isaacson, lead historian here at Rock Island Auction Company, here today to talk to you about a selection of long guns from the Tom Lewis collection in our upcoming May 13th, 14th, and 15th Premier Firearms Auction. So as you can see before me, we have an incredible array of European high art firearms with, you know, incredible work between engraving, carving, the actual quality of the stocks themselves, you know, the whole gamut. Like, each one of these guns is a work of art as much as it is a functional firearm. We've got four early rifles, and we've also got two smoothbore hunting guns here at the back. So the first one we've got here in the front is a 54 caliber flintlock Jaeger rifle. And what's really cool about this one, aside from the fact that it's got a beautifully figured stock, is it actually has a rifled brass barrel. So if you take a look at the muzzle, you can see this has got, you know, traditional German style rifling, but it's a brass barrel. You do not see a lot of brass barreled rifles. On top of that, it's got beautiful classic engraving. You've got some really nice designs on the brass furniture, both, you know, cast designs and engraving. And if I flip it over, I really, really enjoy the side plate on this gun. It's got a nice pierced side plate with scroll work and a cool mask element. And while I've got the gun flipped on this side, you can see on the butt especially just how fancy the pattern is within this wood. And then it's also accented by some really nice floral and scroll carving here. Now if I flip it back over to this side again and you take a look at the brass lock, so like the brass barrel, it's got a brass lock, pretty neat. It's got more mask designs, and there's also a deer scene here at the center of the lock plate. So the next one on my right is this beautiful Jaeger rifle here. This rifle is by Anton Mach. It's a 57 caliber flintlock Jaeger rifle from roughly 1730 to 1750. If you go ahead and look at the top of the barrel, it's got Anton Mach signed right on top. This one's got a, you know, an iron or steel barrel, and you can see again it's got traditional German style rifling. What's interesting about this one is, unlike the last one, there's not a whole lot of metalwork on this one. There is some nice little engraving here, some nice accents on the metal components, but the stock has some really nice, you know, classical Baroque carving. You've got some floral motifs. You've actually got a deer scene here on the back of the butt, right behind the cheek piece. So it's got beautiful work on the stock, and looking back on this side, it's got a, you know, classic German wooden patch box here on the right-hand side. So a really nice early to mid 18th century German flintlock rifle. At the back on the right here, we've got a 52 caliber smoothbore flintlock hunting gun. This is an even earlier example. This one's from the mid 17th century. And again, it's got a beautiful amount of work on it. If you take a look along the top of the barrel, you've got, you know, really nice high relief sculpting. Even the rear sight here is nicely sculpted, and then it's got some really nice floral designs around it. You've got figures here and here. And then what really sets this one apart, you can see it's got an earlier style stock on it, and then they used that big, you know, kind of paddle butt style buttstock to do a really nice, highly detailed relief carved scene here on the right side. The gun at the back left here is probably the most extravagant gun on the table right now. This is an engraved wheel lock sporting gun with extensive scrimshaw stock inlays. It's roughly 6 bore, and it's a smoothbore gun, but it does have front and rear sights, just like the last smoothbore gun did. And you can see it's got a good amount of length to it, but what really sets this gun apart is just the incredible amount of work on the stock. If you look, I mean, literally from the muzzle all the way to the butt, it's inlaid, and each of the inlays is carved. It's got a wide variety of designs. You know, it's not just one design repeating all over. You've got all kinds of different motifs. Over here on the left side, you can see it's got some beautiful mask designs, you know, some bestial motifs. Then back here, you've got some nice, you know, putti or cupids inlaid on the left side on the cheek piece. Some nice rope designs here along the way. I mean, just the whole thing. You could look at this thing from the muzzle to the butt and just keep finding more and more intricate little details all throughout the entire stock. So on the middle left here, we've got a continental European, likely Dutch, you know, roughly around 1700, 52 caliber flintlock sporting rifle. And this one's, again, you can see it's got some nice early rifling. You got, you know, a small low brass blade front sight, a nice rear sight with a second flip up leaf and a really nice little scroll accent here. And let me show you, like, the stock design is just really great. You've got, you know, it's a full length stock. You've got nice molding and interesting wavy line designs, not like some simpler, easier straight lines. You've got, you know, complex designs there. You've got really nice raised relief scroll carving throughout the stock, including here on the fore end and then back here on the patch box lid. And the metalwork is also really ornate on this one. You've got some nice, you know, raised scroll designs. You've got this really complex pierced wrist escutcheon. You've got little mask elements built into some of the architecture. And then if you look up here, I really like these interesting serpentine designs here on the butt plate tang. And then when I flip it over, you can see you've got a really, really nice serpentine design on this pierced side plate as well. Just a beautiful work of art, but that is also a functional firearm that was made to be taken out in the field and taken out for the hunt. All right, the final gun here on my front left is a 72 caliber Swiss flintlock hunting rifle. And you can see, kind of like the American long rifles, the Swiss rifle is actually relatively long, and it has got incredible work. On this one, it's mostly concentrated on the stock. You can see it's basically carved all the way from the fore end cap, all the way through the butt. You've got seams on the cheek rest here and also on the right side as well. Just beautiful hunting seams. But then you've also got this like wood style texture on the wrist and these wood seams all along the fore end. I mean, it's really interesting, a really nice piece of work. Just a beautiful, you know, Swiss flintlock rifle with a lot of beautiful embellishment all the way from the muzzle to the butt. Six beautiful European muzzle-loading sporting guns from the Tom Lewis collection in our upcoming May 13th, 14th, and 15th Premier Firearms Auction.